But there is one more thing.
This is how it all started. The app economy.
Here's why apps might just be the next big thing.
There's no sign this is slowing down. It's 2021. We're talking about 6.7 billion connected devices.
It seems like there's an app for everything. Our daughter downloaded something called the iFart app.
I'm not what you call a gamer. Of course I've played that. My kid loves it. My mom has it on her phone.
I don't think there's anyone left in the world who hadn't played that.
Mobile games are much bigger than people think. Last year, 40% of all app downloads were games. It's a $76 billion industry. That's more than music, more than movies.
I don't think many of us could live without our phones, okay? Mine's in my hand right now. I'm on it constantly.
Over the last decade, apps have become a crucial part of our lives. We're all part of the app economy. Your parents, your workplace, this cat, all these people. You, me. That's me, by the way. Hi.
This is very cheesy.
And then, of course, there's the amazing people who actually make the apps and games.
I'm Murat. I make games for a living. For the last 8 years, I was working in oil and gas. I was in an oil rig in the Atlantic Ocean, working 12, 13 hours shifts. And I used my spare time to make games, which was my passion. That was the best part of the day for me, actually. Doing full-time game development was my dream, so I got my game published. Now we have 6 million downloads and counting. I want to make games I always wanted to make since I was a kid. It's still the best part of the day for me.
And I'm sure you'd also recognize some of these names.
Activision's a leader in making games across every platform and has been for over 40 years.
Zynga is a global leader in interactive entertainment. We've had over 1 billion people play our games.
We have a rather large portfolio of casual games. Disney Emoji Blitz, Cookie Jam, Panda Pop.
We are, of course, famous for our Angry Birds franchise that we are proudly taking to the next level.
You probably know this, but that last company started small, and now their app is on plushies, toys, and even the big screen. But there's a lot more to a smash hit than just making a great game.
There's a fundamental difference between a great app and a great app business. The app economy is huge and only getting bigger. And as it does, it's become easier than ever to create an app, but harder than ever to create an app business.
It's absolutely easier to create a game today than it was 5 years ago. The barrier to entry is lower. The software makes it a lot easier. But the barrier to success is incredibly high.
Anyone can build a game and sub into the App Store. But of course, the competition there is very fierce.
It's crowded with bad games, good games.
When we're put in the same context as everybody advertising on Facebook or everybody advertising on Google, it's much harder to stand out.
This is a really fast-moving market. We're looking for people who understand what's coming and have a view across the ecosystem that in some ways is broader than what we have.
So there, of course, you need a great partners that can help you to grow the game and make it successful together.
Why should I stand?
Take one.
That's where IronSource comes in. No, I don't like that. Go back.
We started IronSource with a clear mission: to help developers turn their apps into scalable, successful businesses in one of the most exciting and fastest growing markets in history. Building a great app business requires so much more than just creating an app. More than ever, developers need a single, powerful platform to turn their great ideas into great businesses.
We operate in an emerging category of platforms, which have helped to enable these massive explosions of growth in the game industry. Of these, we offer the most comprehensive business platform for apps and mobile games, and today we power the business growth of 87% of the top 100 most downloaded games.
Yeah. Free-to-play games are so important now because they open the funnel. They maximize the number of players who can access it, and then it's up to the games to retain the players by giving them the ability to progress in a game without necessarily paying.
Well-designed advertising in games with clear value proposition for the player can really make the game more fun, increase retention.
We always try to make sure to put the player experience first. And by and large, what that means is that we focus on ad placements that bring value to users, more so than just giving them something. We want to make sure we're giving them something of major utility in the game.
We chose IronSource because the platform would allow us to achieve our ambitions. We don't want a game that's pay to win. It's very, very, very important for us. If IAP is the only way for us to get revenue, we're kind of locking out a pretty significant percentage of the player base. whereas ads allow us to reinvest and kind of grow the community.
User acquisition and ad monetization are sort of two sides of the same coin. You can almost think of it like a flywheel where you acquire users, then you look at their behavior, and that combined data allows you to do better targeting and know which users to monetize at what price points. And ironSource helps us connect those two pieces of data.
But there is one more thing. There's a whole other part of the app economy that you've probably never thought about.
We've tailored our platform to meet the needs of the two core constituents of the app economy: app developers who provide the content and telecom operators who provide the connectivity that that content runs on. And that focus has enabled us to reach 2.3 billion monthly active users.
If you think about it, every app user in the world is a telco user. Telecom providers want to do more than just provide connectivity. We help telcos engage and communicate with their customers throughout the entire device lifecycle. By incorporating app and service recommendation directly into the device experience, we also give app developers an incredible new channel to connect with potential users at the moments when they're wired to install new apps.
When you come in and you're excited because finally you're eligible to trade in your phone, there is sort of a great moment to reach out to users at the very beginning of their experience with a new smartphone. And that was a great match to our business needs.
There's 10,000 things happening on the carrier side. There's 10,000 things happening on the developer side. And I think about the simplicity that ironSource brings to the end app developer in integrating with these really advanced strategic components of the carrier ecosystem.
The app economy has created a transformational opportunity to connect with customers and build incredible businesses. We know what it takes to build a business in the app economy and how to help others build theirs.
The experience working with the ironSource team has been fantastic. We were really happy with the technology.
I have been really impressed by the level of innovation.
ironSource, over the 6 years we work with them, continues to be a trusted partnership, and the relationship has only grown over time and gotten better.
I think we are always looking for the best partners who really can deliver what they promise. And ironSource is one of those key partners for us that are really ticking those boxes.
With ironSource, I could talk with anybody in the team. I got monetization, UA, game design, game artists all together. Full focus on the game to make it a success like it was their own game.
As the impact of the app economy on our daily lives continues to grow, we will be there, powering the businesses of those powering the apps.
That was great. That was really good.
Okay, I go.
Can we just get it all one more time? From the top.